guys or whatever, but we're underway as Miller will jump center against Guyman, and Guyman wins the jump. T.Y. Curtis in the backcourt will walk it across the timeline. Dixie and Canyonview, state 3A quarterfinals. They go immediately into Guyman. He gets it out to Curtis. Now baseline to Caden Elzey. Elzey up off the glass, no good. Rebound, Guyman has it ripped away, gets it back out to Corbin Elzey. Elzey finds his brother for two.
Wow, what a pass. That was just a catch in the right in perfect place on the backside, lay it up and in.
Pay immediate dividends starting Corbin because he gets that loose ball and kicks it over to his brother for 2 points. And the score is 2-0 Dixie. Canyonview working the O, and we're going to have maybe a holding foul. Now, they have Corbin Elzey on Blackner, and he just got called right there for a hold, chasing Blackner around the lane. But immediately we have a sub as Tanner Cuff comes in for Stewart.
Stewart just got the foul. And
is he the one that got the
foul?
Yeah, okay.
They call him for a hold on that backside.
Well, that's why he sat down. Ball comes in, quick shot up, and no good. That was by Joey Lambeth.
And the quick rebound by Guyman, that's what he's got to do.
Now the hard drive, Elzey leaves it for Guyman. Guyman back to Elzey. Elzey in heavy traffic, shot up, and he can't get the roll. Might have been partially blocked by Blackner. Going the other way is Branson Blackner, number 30. He's the star for this team. Crosses over, pulls up, three-pointer from the angle. Lefty, it's good. Horizon Homes three for Branson Blackner.
Boy, you warned us. They can all shoot the three, and he was comfortable in that one.
Corbin says, I can shoot the three, too, and he does. Corbin Elzey for a three.
Now maybe that's already paid dividends. A great pass, and now a long three-pointer for Corbin Elzey.
5-3, Dixie on top. Cuff, little bump, no harm, no foul, into Miller. Miller inside, tries the skip pass, and it's stolen away. Tanner Cuff with the steal. Now to Elzey. Elzey crosses over, scoop shot, up, no good. Rebound taken down by Christensen.
I don't know how he even got to the bucket with that one. He took off, I think, from the other end of the court. He was in the air a long time.
Huxford to Miller, back outside. Three-pointer up, no good. That was Lambeth from deep. And Dixie on the glass. Fast pace so far. We saw a lot of scoring in that other game earlier. Curtis tries to go inside to Guyman, but pass is too low and too hot for Richard, who sporting a new haircut as of last Friday. I kind of like the old hair, Mike. I'm not getting used to this short stuff.
He
makes him look like he's about 12.
Oh,
I don't know too many 6'7", 12-year-olds, but he looks really young with that short haircut.
He does.
5-3, the score early on. They haven't actually put the extra couple of points up for Dixie. As Miller spins inside, goes around the horn. As Canyonview working the offense. Crossover by Blackner, drives in the lane. Little scoop shot, got bumped, no harm, no foul. Rebound to Elzey. Elzey double dribbled, got away with it, leaves it off for Curtis. Curtis lays it up and in.
Boy, Curtis is so confident. Nice job, kind of got up in the air, shielded him off and laid it off the glass.
And the scoreboard is now caught up to the actual score, 7-3, Dixie on top. On our one-loss scoreboard, they go in the high post. Cuff nearly gets a steal, knocks it out of, no. They're gonna say it's off of Canyonview, and a Canyonview player went over the scorer's table. Hope he's okay. I think that was Porter Miller. Porter's a tough guy.
He says, I'm all right.
He's a linebacker slash running back slash tight end slash get out of my way, and he took the scorer's table out there.
Looks at his coach, gives him the thumbs up, like, don't take me out. I'm really all right here.
Now they need him in the game.
Now he and Sam's back, and they were kind of jostling with each other there.
Guyman inside, hands it off to Curtis. Curtis in heavy traffic, has to get rid of it. Corner three by Elzey. No good, but the offensive rebound put back by Sam Stewart.
Boy, great job. Just in the right position at the right time. The rebound came right down to him. He laid it up and in.
Dixie, four baskets, four different players so far in this game. Canyonview, a little give and go. Blackner crashes in there. No foul either way. Could have been a charge. Could have been a block. Instead, it's just a basket.
And I'm going to say it. I believe that the officials, and I actually like this, in state playoff, they let them play.
Letting them play. I agree. Now the third game, we've seen it. Three out of the corner. Stewart, no good. Short rimmed it. And Blackner on the glass. Branson with the lefty dribble. Now he switches to right. Gets a screen at the top of the key and pulls up. Looking for help now. Goes to Huxford. Huxford top of the key. Looking for help. Stares down the barrel. Now he goes left side. That is Christensen. Christensen in the lane. Wanted to shoot, but Guyman was there protecting the rim. Back to Huxford. Ran the horn, they go. Miller, long three-pointer. Miller, that's no good. Rebound tipped out right to Lambeth. Lambeth can't get the shot, but then a push-off called inside on Cash Christensen.
Yeah, sometimes you can't ignore something, and that was the definite. He took both hands, and they were extended out. He looked at the official like, oh, you saw that? Yes, I did, he said.
Yes, I did. Now we look at a little 2-2-1 full-court press for Canyonview. Well, it's not because they drop back into a man-to-man full-court. Looked like a 2-2-1.
You're right. They set it up, then they drop back immediately.
Curtis in the forecourt, uncontested for the most part. Now he'll back things out, and Dixie will run there. Oh, they lead it 9-5 here against the Canyonview Falcons. Quarterfinal action. Left side, it goes to Caden Elzey. Baseline to Stewart, back to Elzey. Elzey on the angle left, dribbles in the lane. Tries to kick it in the corner. Ball is tipped and stolen away by Canyonview, but it goes back to Elzey. Elzey into Guyman. Guyman no looked at it, and he should have looked because his teammate Stewart had drifted out to the three line. He passed it where he had been, and that's a turnover.
Again, that's a case I think, if I was the coach, I'd say, you're 2 feet from the basket, big guy. Put it in.
Yep. Sometimes.
That close.
We've seen it this year. Richard Guyman has been a little too unselfish. And now the ball, they're going to say touched by Dixie. I thought maybe it just got thrown away by.
Well, I think they're very fortunate. It might have been touched by Dixie, but he was passing to where the guy used to be, like the other end.
First appearance for Dixie by Camden Flinders. Flinders is a three-point bomber. Of course, Canyonview's got like five of those, so.
Yeah.
As Lambeth goes left and he throws it away. Too wide for Blackner. Blackner had, I think he was slamming on the brakes at about the three line, and Lambeth threw it really closer to the Dixie cheerleaders. As you might guess, with two teams a long way from home, not a lot of crowd here at the Smith Spectrum. Trying to get it into Guyman, a bad pass by Flinders and a turnover.
Yeah, a good guess, or not maybe, just a good idea by the defense. Stepped in front with a deflection.
Huxford drives, lefty shot up and good. Oh, they let him go and it rolled out. Thought he was going to hit that one, had a good look at it. Nearly a turnover, but Stewart comes away with it and he throws it away. Dixie's playing a little bit out of their character right now.
I think both teams a little bit. Maybe they're just tight. Maybe all this idea of, hey, we got to, because if you don't win today, you don't win the state championship. There's a little extra pressure.
Coach Potter was telling me that they got to do a little shoot around at the last few days at the Centrum to try to get used to a bigger arena. I said, but what about here? He says, we really haven't done anything here. They don't let you. Wow. Three underway is up and good. That's Detling. Perry Detling comes in and gets a three and makes it a one-point game for the Falcons. Right straight away, top of the key. Who knew he could shoot? That's his 15th of the year, though, so they should have known.
Apparently he's done that before, yeah.
9-8. Dixie on top, technically the lower seed, even though the Flyers are higher ranked. Into Guyman. Guyman, it'll stop and pop. No good in the lane. And clearing the rebound is Canyonview. Guyman probably got away with a forearm offensive foul on that one, but no call. Inside, Detling. Detling misses the shot off the rim, a little too hard. Now the fast break. Flinders in the lane. Triple teamed, and he lost it. Oh, stolen back by Elzey. Back to Flinders. And I could not see a thing
Elzey
because
was
the
out
ref,
of bounds.
Ref stepped right in front of me.
Yeah, the return pass went back to Elzey, and he caught it and looked down. 1 foot was out of bounds. So turnover, give the ball back. This is a very fast-paced go-to kind of a basketball game.
But, you know, we had a fast-paced game in that Desert Hills contest. But it was a lot of scoring, 20-16 at the end of the first quarter. It's a fast-paced game here, but we had 90 seconds to go. It's only 9-8. In the forecourt, Blackner has it poked away by Corbin Elzey, but they get it back. Christensen nearly threw it away. Blackner got it back, though, behind the back pass. Swinging outside to Detling. He can't get the three under the way. Ball tipped away and stolen by Dixie. Ahead to Cuff. Cuff on the fast break. One-on-one, lays it up and in.
Nice job by Cuff. Looked back, saw the defense, perfectly positioned himself between him, or the guy, and the ball, laid it up and in.
And in hockey, they call it a one-timer pass where you rebound and pass it at the same time. That's what Guyman did to get that one. Shot up, boy, over the big guy. Nice drive by Joey Lambeth. That's his first basket.
Boy, I like that. Lambeth gives away a good foot
on
the defender, but he laid it in.
Used his body and shot it way away. Now it's 11-10. 40 seconds to go in the first. Good ball game so far. Dixie won the first matchup by 16 up at Canyonview. Nice drive in the lane. Elzy can't get the shot to go. That's Caden Elzy. Or was it Curtis on the drive? It was Curtis.
Yeah, it was.
Curtis will go to the free throw line. I believe that's the first foul of the game, second foul of the game on Canyon View. And T.Y. Curtis will go to the line. Who did they give the foul to, Mike?
The foul was to number four.
Abe Huxley.
There you go.
Curtis can't get the free throw. That is the first free throw for either team now with 30 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Boy, you talk about free throws. For those who may have missed the game this morning, Desert Hills couldn't buy one until the very end of the game. They hit six consecutive free throws and won the game.
Second one up and good by Curtis, and it's a 12-10 Dixie lead. We are about 25 seconds away from the end of the first quarter. As Lambeth brings it in the forecourt, right side to Huxford. Now top of the key to Detling. And Lambeth. Lambeth holding on to it, probably looking for Blackner. He gets a screen from Blackner. Spins around, trying to get it to him, but it's tipped away and stolen by Dixie. But as he's making the steal, stepping out of bounds was the Dixie player, and that is Kaysen Batima, or Batima. Batima.
Yeah, actually, they fought each other, and there's a steal. Dixie, good anticipation again.
T.Y. Curtis, one-on-one, fast break, lays it up and in with 3 seconds to go in the quarter. Canyonview will try a full court shot at the buzzer, but that's going to be off the mark, and Dixie will take a 14-10 lead on our one-loss scoreboard after one period. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit Centricom.com to learn more.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit Centricom.com today.
Logan, Utah is the location. Andy and Mike with you, and it's a 14-10 game. Mike, what do you come away with in quarter number one?
I'm pretty impressed. A good game. Again, the athleticism of both teams apparent. I think the one key, I believe, for Canyon View, they've pretty much taken the big guy out of the game. They bother him. He's good. He's got a couple of rebounds, but he has zero on the points.
I think he's only shot maybe once
or
twice.
Yeah, not look. He overpasses a couple of times.
Well, Guyman, no points, but Dixie getting some help from its guards. Corbin Elzy with 3, Ty Curtis with 5. Outside is Detling. Detling with a jump stop, has it tipped away, gets it back. Kicks it outside, 3-pointer out of the left side. Ooh, did he mean to bank it? The bank is open for Toby Potter.
I was watching Sam Story. He looked at him and goes, yes, oh my word, it went in. He thought it was way off, and it was. At least it started that way.
Inside, they try to go alley-oop to Guyman. Bodies hit the floor. Two of those bodies are Dixie players, so Canyon View with numbers. Detling back outside to Blackner. Blackner one-on-one with Sam Stewart covering him. By the way, they're saying that last shot was a 2, not a 3.
Ah.
Offensive rebound taken after the miss by Blackner to Huxford. Out around the left side, another 3 underway. In and out, back in for Branson Blackner.
Wow. They're not afraid to shoot it. There's no doubt about that. That rattled around, but did fall home.
And Canyonview's got the lead, 15-14, 3 the other way. Stewart can't get it to go. A rebound to Christensen. And Canyonview can slow things down now. They've got a one-point lead here in the state quarterfinals. Blackner thought about the stop and pop. Now he drives in the lane. Shot blocked easily by Guyman. Gets it to Corbin Elzy. That was a pretty easy block for Richard. He just waited and then and palm the ball. Could have maybe been a jump ball.
You might want to challenge him, but that's not the way to do it. Go right at it. He just stood there and palmed it out of bounds.
Tried the entry pass to Cuff, and he is fouled on the entry by Detling. And it is Well, they changed that 3 to a 2, and then they changed it back to a 3 now. So it is 16-14, and I have to scribble again in my scorebook. With Toby Potter credit for a 3, and now we're going the other way with it.
Yeah, they went in quickly. Guyman put it up and did not go down. Rebound to Canyon View.
Kick in the corner. Miller for 3. No good. That's a brick. Rebound to Guyman. If he'd have wanted, he could have gone one-on-one fast break, but Richard deciding
not
probably not a good
forte.
Idea. Yeah. Elzy back out to Cuff. Open 3 for Tanner. Cuff is up and good. And Cuff with a big Horizon Homes 3.
Yeah, that's a great shot. He was open. Why not? It looked good. He was very confident in that one.
17-16, Dixie. Ran the horn, they go. A little leaping leaner up, no good. Rebound, hits the deck, and Caden Elzy comes away with it. Shooter on that one was Dastrup. Inside, trying to go to Guyman. Guyman lost it, but saved it out to Cuff. Cuff has it tipped away. Boy, can you very active with the hands.
Yep.
They try to go into Guyman, but it hit the rim and over his head, and that's a turnover.
Either you want to be a little bit off on the pass, a little bit more, and it would have went in, or a little lower on that.
3 out of the corner, Canyon View. That's no good. Rebound the other way. Fast break now for Stewart. Stewart has to back things off. It was 1-on-3, and he'll leave it for Cuff for 3. That's short. Rebound. Sam Stewart hustles and gets it. Ball goes to the floor. We'll have a held ball, but there were 3 Canyon View players around the ball. Stewart just went in between them all and grabbed the basket.
I like his, aggressiveness there. He went right in. I think possibly could have been, I don't know. They got it about the same time. I thought he had it wrapped it up, but there was no timeout, so they did the right thing. Tied him up,
they have
the jump ball.
Completely screwed the scoreboard up. It should be 17-16. They've got 19-14 on the board. They gave that last 3 by Dixie to Canyon View. I don't know what they're doing with the scoreboard. It is complete. It's been jacked up all game long. Curtis in the lane, stop and pop, and he is fouled.
Nice job by T.Y. there. He switched to the left hand, Andy, and he forced the foul. There's your scoreboard.
Well, they got it backwards, though. It should be 17-16, Dixie. In the quarter, 2 threes for Canyon View, 1 by Potter, 1 by Blackner. In the quarter for Dixie, they have a 3 is all. And did he make the free throw, Mike?
He did. Yep, up and good. But it didn't count. No, I'm just kidding. It's not.
I don't know anymore.
There we go.
It should be 18-16 now. They've got 17-16 up.
There we go.
And Curtis misses a second, and I think the scoreboard is finally correct.
They've caught up, Andy. We're in good shape here.
You would hope you get pretty good scoreboard work from a big arena like this, big venue. Blackner has it, had a 3, and City goes inside to Potter. Potter gives it off, and it's blocked and stolen out of there. Curtis on the dead run. Can he catch it in time? He does, but the layup's no good. Tipped out, and that should be Dixie ball out of bounds.
Yeah, by the time he got there, and you're right, the pass was over his head, he kind of had to really reach back with that one. Couldn't get the angle.
That's tough when you're way under there and the defense is coming hard at you. Dixie by 2, halfway through quarter number 2, trying to get it in, and they do. Out to Guyman. Guyman to Flinders, around to Cuff. Cuff just holding on, looking at a man-to-man defense by Canyon View. They have not done switching on the screens yet. Guyman comes out and tries to set a pick, but instead they have to throw it, and throwing it away is Stewart.
Yeah, and looked in size, man, knew had it in the right direction, maybe about a foot too tall. He really threw that up, ended up in the bench.
Coach Rob Potter really brought to me a really kind of a good calming influence and tradition now here at Canyon View. Love that they made it all the way to the semis last year. Lead pass to Porter Miller, but Canyon View can't take advantage. Go to Blackner. Blackner kicks in the corner. Huxford out of the corner. No good. Rebound to Guyman. Dixie wants to run. No numbers, though. And Curtis will slow it down in midcourt.
Good decision by Curtis. He looked up, thought, not really, we don't have the advantage. Pulled it out.
3:52 to go in the quarter. Dixie working the offense. In the corner is Cuff. Actually have, 3 starters on the bench right now? Bottoma right now with the basketball, looking to get it into Cuff, or to Guyman, but Guyman nowhere near the basket. He has to give it up.
Canyon, out of Flinders. You're in a pretty good matchup zone right now.
Yeah, they switch the defenses. Bottoma with the drive, and he is tackled in the lane. He's going to be okay. But he will get free throws, I believe he was shooting. Yeah, they're going to say 2 shots on the play. personal foul called to Joey Lambeth.
Bonema steps in there. 3:26 time to go here in the first half of play. Again, a quick first half.
Bonema misses the free throw. He'll have one more coming. By the way, our score and time updates brought to you by the Air Care Professionals, heating and air conditioning. Hard to think about heating right now considering where we are in the great white north. I mean, air conditioning,
air
rather.
Conditioning, yes.
It's, you think a lot about heating. In fact, I had my heater cranked in the hotel room.
Bottom gets the second free throw.
19-16 Dixie in the forecourt to Porter Miller. Miller kicks it back outside to Huxford for three. Too hard, no good. Guyman fights for the rebound, tips it out to Curtis. Curtis ahead to Bottoma. Bottoma looking for Flinders. No, he goes all the way to the hole, and he is fouled. How about this Bottoma guy? He has not played much this year, Mike. I've only seen him. I've probably done maybe 8 to 10 Dixie games. I've seen him maybe three times this year.
That's a pretty aggressive move. It looked like he was going in, and he looked for someone to pass to and thought, no, I'm just gonna force it up there, and he was fouled.
I believe they gave the foul to Christensen. The coach said, hey, he had his hands up, and the ref says, hey, but he hit him in the head.
Yeah.
Did he make the first? He did
yes.
Make the first one. Two out of three from the line for Carson. I think I called him Kaysen earlier. It's Carson. And that's Carson with a K.
Got a pair.
And it's up and good. He's 3 out of 4 for the young guy with very little experience, but he's out there getting the job done. 21-16, Dixie by 5. In the forecourt it comes. High pass, but nice catch by Miller. Miller stepped through and did a really nice pass fake and then laid it up and in.
Wow, did a great job. Just held the ball out. Look! And then when they did, he switched to the right hand, laid it in.
21-18. Canview within three. Dixie in their road blues looking to get it in the interior of the zone. They go to Guyman. Guyman hands it off Curtis. Curtis blocked from behind and out of bounds. No foul either way. Miller tried to take a charge. Would have been a close call charge block, but
yeah.
The block was from behind and it was a clean block and out of bounds.
Once again, pretty good job.
I like the no-call. Yeah, I like
it. Too.
Ball comes into Bottoma. Looking inside, and City goes right side to Flinders. Into Guyman. Nice catch. Layup up and good. There's your first bucket for the big guy, Mike.
Yeah, I like that. He looked at him, got a perfectly placed up high, and he did a good job of keeping it up there and laid it in.
Now they break the press. Joey Lambeth, there's one guy you cannot leave for Canyonview, and Lambeth buries it.
And they steal it away. They go the other way. Pass back, layup. Got it.
And wow. Abe Huxford with his first basket after the turnover. And just like that, we're tied at 23 with 2 minutes to go in the first half.
It's defense. Defense stepped up, started that last offensive series.
Little turnaround jumper, 15-footer, no good. Rebound, Guyman. Guyman up off the glass and good in heavy traffic.
See, I like his aggressiveness there. He took it, didn't look to anybody to pass. He just lowered his shoulder and then put it up and in.
Now a steal the other way, and Caden Elsie will go uncontested for two, and Dixie's up by four.
Wow. Don't look down, Andy.
I know. I try to write it down on my scorebook, and boom, boom, it's over with. Now going the other way. Blackner drives baseline on Guyman, kicks adrift in the corner. Shot or the ball lost but saved by Canyonview to the double team. Inside it goes to Miller, back out to Huxford. Huxford drives left. Kicks it back outside to Lambeth. He can't hit the three. Rebound tipped out, and Curtis has it. Curtis ahead to Flinders. Flinders will lay it up and in.
Wow.
Camden Flinders.
I think T.Y.'s got an extra set in the back of his head.
How did he know? Yeah.
I don't know how he saw his teammate.
Minute to go. Dixie on a 6-0 run. The Flyers lead 29-23. Screen for Huxford by Miller. He'll drive into lane. Give it off. Ball stolen away by Bottoma. And we're going the other way with it. And I think I heard Carson's dad say, good job, Carson, right behind us.
There we go.
And Dixie can maybe hold for one. We're at 35 seconds.
Well, you know they will.
And Dixie up by 6. The ideal thing here, the score is at least a 6-point lead when you go to halftime. You don't want to go too early. Flinders fakes the drive, now backs it out. Now drives again. Has it tipped away, but gets it back. Now Guyman back outside to Curtis. Down to 15 seconds now in the half. Dixie by 6. And Curtis just hanging on right near center court. 8 seconds to go. Time to go. Curtis doesn't take the screen. Drives in. Kicks in the corner. Bottoma has his three blocked. Gets it back. Jumper up. No good. And that's how the half will end, a 29-23 Dixie lead. We're going to take a two-minute timeout. We do have something coming up for you on radio. Andy Thompson's going to give us an update and kind of story about the game from earlier today with Desert Hills victory in that game over Stansberry. But right now we're going to take a two-minute break. We'll come back and get some stats for you, all that coming up here. It is halftime, brought to you by InfoWest.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard, break time at the office, or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom Cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Want to make your HD TV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. And we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Okay, yeah, and I'll just take another break here on the live stream. Take 3 minutes. That's good.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard, break time at the office, or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom Cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Want to make your HD TV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. And we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit Centricom.com to learn more.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit Centricom.com today.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit Centricom.com today.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard. Break time at the office or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit Centricom.com to learn more.
All right, welcome back. We are looking at some highlights for those of you joining us on TV and streaming on the internet. Highlights, see Corbin Elzey hitting a big three in the first half. Dixie actually did not turn to the three much in this game, Mike. They only had two in the entire half.
Well, they started out gutting from the outside, but I like the fact they go inside. That's where their power has been, and they obviously play very well. When the three's missing, go inside.
Yeah, now one thing about it, and you're going to see on these highlights, Dixie did a really good job of rebounding the basketball in the
right.
First half. That was, you know, when I talked with Coach Turley in that Desert Hills game earlier today, he said that was a real issue for them, was rebounding. And you got to realize at this level, when you're in a state tournament, it's do or die. You lose your season, you know, you blew it. You have no chance to be a champion. There's a nice layup there by Cuff. And so teams, you know, rebounding is a lot about desire. The desire's a little higher and a little stronger when you get to the state tournament level. And, you know, I thought Stansberry rebounded the ball very well. Dixie is doing an excellent job. In fact, you look at the numbers, Mike, in the first half, Dixie with 21 rebounds. There's another offensive rebound. And only 8 rebounds in the first half for Canyonview.
Wow.
That is downright dominant on the glass for the Dixie Flyers in the first half. And, of course, leading the way, Richard Guyman with 5. But Sam Stewart has been Johnny on the spot, too. He's got 5 rebounds, including 2 on the offensive end.
So I watched that replay again of that 3 that came off the backboard and in. Sam Stewart couldn't believe it. He just dropped his head like, how did he ever get that one to go in,
yeah.
You know?
See Tanner Cuff hit a 3. That was one, again, just 2 3-pointers made by Dixie in the first half. They were 2-for-7 from deep, but they were 9-for-17 from everywhere else, so shooting over 50% from the floor, not counting the 3-pointers. Dixie from the free throw line is 5 out of 8. And how about Canyonview? They have not shot a free throw in the first half. Does that surprise you?
That does surprise me, absolutely. Yeah, you would expect a little bit more. It's kind of fun watching the replays. They just showed that the big guy with his one good power move. He caught the ball high. He stayed up high. That's what he's got to learn to do.
Left there by Abe Huxford.
Yep.
And then here's Guyman. I thought he got fouled on this one by a couple of different guys. One pushing from behind, the other slapping from in front, but he made the shot anyway. And then there's that beautiful steal and lay-in by Caden Elzey. I think they had one more breakaway. So we are getting a little feedback here. 29-23 is our score at the half. Let's take one final one-minute timeout. Be back with more after this.
Want to make your HDTV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. and we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
I guess I turned my microphone up. That'll help a little bit here, won't it? Sorry, on the radio side, we are experiencing some difficulty, so we apologize for that. But we are into, Andy, the third quarter, 29-23 at the half, and right back to live action.
Yeah, it's a six-point lead for Dixie. Now, remember, Canyonview had tied it at 23, but Dixie ended the first half on a 6-0 run, as we catch on our video feed. Video replay there of Blackner. Blackner gets fouled and he'll hit a free throw. First one is up and good. Branson Blackner ended up with 8 points in the first half for Canyonview. And the second free throw also up and good. Pardon me, as Dixie now a 4-point edge here with 7:40 to go in the third quarter. Hopefully we get all our technical problems squared away and we can get this thing rolling correctly. T.Y. Curtis gives it to Caden Elzey. Elzey, nice move in the lane, up and under move, will not go, and a nice rebound by Porter Miller in traffic.
Boy, strong down low, but now he has it tipped away.
Curtis tried to go and got bumped pretty hard by Lambeth, and that'll be a personal foul number two on Joey.
Well, one thing that didn't change for the first half, and that's the aggressiveness of both teams. They're still going hard at each other.
It'll be Dixie ball to inbound. They get it to Corbin Elzey. Elzey now one dribble, two dribbles, goes between the legs and gives it off to Guyman in the high post. Back out to Corbin Elzey. Elzey, a little teardrop from 10. No good. Rebound to Blackner. Here come the Falcons, and they lose it. That's a turnover. Curtis looking for help. Nowhere to go, so he backs things out, and they'll start things over. Dixie, 29, Canyonview, 25. Ball nearly thrown away, and it is thrown away as Kay Nails, he can't save it on the kickout by Guyman. And I feel like this game's a little bit like our broadcast, a little sloppy,
a little disjointed,
and things going wrong.
And I think I've seen more throwing to where someone used to be than I've seen in a long time. In other words, the anticipation, and it's not what it's actually going on.
Blackner drives in the lane, gives it off to Porter Miller. He is fouled. Almost had a chance for a three-point play, but the ball wouldn't fall.
They're going to get Caden Elzey on the personal foul. He had that look on his face like, I can't, oh, me? But that's exactly what happened.
It was the other Elzey. It was the little one, though. It was Corbin who got the foul. And Porter Miller to the line for the first time tonight, and he misses the free throw. By the way, Canyonview did not shoot a free throw in the first half. They now have, in the first minute, 19 seconds, three free throws. One more coming for Miller. And that one rattles out as well. So Canyonview, 2-for-4 in the second half from the line. Dixie lead remains 4. Curtis gets it across the timeline. Now goes high post to Elzey. Elzey, turnaround, 15-footer, swish. Nice looking shot by Caden Elzey, his third basket of the game.
Elzey Rose going at it here once again, and up to a 6-point lead for the Flyers.
Canyonview keeping this one close, like we saw Stansbury do with Desert Hills. And shot blocked out of there as Richard Guyman read it all the way and sent it into the third row here at the Smith Spectrum.
Yeah, perfectly played that time by the big guy. Kind of followed it, knew he had the height and just waited till the ball went up, knocked it out of bounds.
Ball comes into Miller. Miller hands it off, has it nearly stolen away. Tipped out of bounds by Corbin Elsie. I think Elsie, you know, is a kid that maybe doesn't get enough credit for how much defense he plays, and I think that's why he's starting today.
He's done a good job so far, made a big, I think a big difference in the game.
Lambeth drives in the lane, can't get a shot away, back outside to Blackner. Blackner one-on-one with Elsie. Now he gets a screen from Miller. Problem is that brings Stewart into play. Now the kick into the corner, three out of the corner, in and out, no good. Tipped up and finally saved by Corbin Elsie. Now the long TD pass caught by Stewart. Stewart drives in, up off the glass, got the nice roll. It's good, Dixie by eight.
I tell you, sometimes you don't put up a great shot, but it worked. That was too hard, but it hit the back rim and bounced straight up and down.
33-25, Dixie, 5.5 to go in the third. Ball stolen away, and a jump ball. Blackner tried the crossover. Elsie, that's Corbin Elsie, read it all the way. Held ball will be Dixie basketball.
Everybody's arguing with each other, the team, the bench, the players.
Now a technical foul has just been called on Corbin Elsie.
Wow.
So now the official's getting a little uppity. All, he said, you want one too?
Yeah, he was warning the other Elsie there.
So Branson Blackner will get technical free throws. This play like this could change a game, Mike. I've seen it happen a couple of times this year.
I was going to say, Andy, I see the look of concern on Coach Cuff. He knows that. He realizes, guys, this is not what you want to do, is let your emotions get away from you.
Blackner hits the first technical free throw. Second one. Three, four dribbles for Branson and swish. Blackner out now with a dozen. I think Coach Cuff wants to know what the technical was for. And I didn't see Elsie say anything. I don't know, maybe he yanked the ball away a little too mean or something.
Coach Cuff didn't like the explanation. His response was, come on. That's all I can say.
I don't like this official.
This official's
taking,
a little out of control.
Kind of taking the attitude of, I'm the man and you got to listen to me. And you can't do that as an official.
Wild stuff here in this one.
Shot up. Beautiful driving shot in the lane by Porter Miller. And it is now a four-point game after the technical free throws and the bucket by Miller.
Yeah, we said it. You never know. But sometimes you do know. That hurts.
Elsie gets a screen from Cup. Pop and stop and pop three. No good. And a rebounding foul called on Sam Stewart.
We want to remind you once again our game today being brought to you in part by InfoWest. Normally we have a nice halftime update, but we had some concerns today. But InfoWest really helps us out. And we appreciate them as well as Dats Trucking. We'll name a Dats Trucking player of the game.
Yeah, post game we'll have some awards to hand out. AWP Playmaker Play of the Game, Dats Trucking Player of the Game, and a Jimmy John Super Sub. Can't be Corbin Elsie because he's a starter. Porter Miller tries to get free in the lane. He's been in that lane a long time. No 3 second call. Ball stolen away by T.Y. Curtis, but he can't stay in bounds.
Great hustle, great anticipation by Curtis, but a little tough to tiptoe down that sideline. Couldn't quite do it.
Right now, 4-0 run for the Falcons as Bottomo will come in again. And Elsie checks out. So we got Curtis, Bottomo, Stewart, Guyman, and Tanner Cuff, coach's son. Drive and kick. Detling can't get a shot away. Out to Huxford. Huxford crosses over at the free throw line. Stop and pop. Left the 14-footer about 13 feet. And the rebound to Curtis. 4:15 to go third quarter. Dixie by four. Flyers have two field goals here in the third quarter. Canby has one field goal and four free throws. Out to Stewart. Now to Curtis. Around the horn they go. Dixie looking for a spark here. Cuff. Has to give it up to Curtis out near half court. Now they swing it to the right side to Bottomo. Bottomo gets a screen from Stewart. Drives baseline. Looking for help. Looking for help. Might have traveled along the baseline. Either stepped on the line or traveled. Either way, it's a turnover.
Yeah, I was just going to say, it doesn't matter which one you call that time because there is a turnover, and the ball will belong to the Falcons. Down, as you point out, just four.
We have not seen Cannon die in this game at all. He is normally the fifth starter. I don't know if he's hurt, sick, suspended. We don't know. But Dixie playing without one of their starters, Cannon died this entire game.
Cam Flinders getting ready to check back in. So.
Drive by Blackner, and Richard Kiteman says, oh, no, you don't. Didn't give him the finger wag like Dikembe, but.
But everything else, but that boy, that was, you know, go back to all of the human fly swatter, whatever you want to say. He was up high and slammed that ball into the seats.
Checking into the game for Dixie is Flinders. Ball stolen away, but again, same thing right along the sideline that Curtis had. Bottom, yep. Can't keep it in bounds. Good hustle, though, and it will be Canyon View ball again. Been a very low-scoring second half. For the most part, a low-scoring game.
Yeah, it has.
Huxford leads it to Lambeth. Lambeth drives in, gives it off to Miller. Miller, spin move. Shot blocked out of there by Guyman. Who else? He's got three or four blocks in this game.
Yep.
Another spin move by Miller.
Another
block shot by Guyman. Ball goes to the floor and finally picked up by Curtis. Curtis on the run. Now he has to slam on the brakes. And stop and go into Guyman, but Guyman can't handle the drop off. And a reaching foul called on Camden Flinders in the exchange. Boy, that was a beautiful move, beautiful pass, but the big fella couldn't hang on, Mike.
Wild and woolly. We got it going on here right now. I tell you, that was back and forth and up and down, and guys really scrapping hard. And they know, a lot at stake with 2 or 3 minutes to go in the third quarter.
6-4 in the third quarter is your score. Canyon View has cut it to a 4-point game. Blackner with the hard drive. Ball stripped out of there by Curtis. No foul. Blackner wasn't calling for one. Good strip by T.Y. Curtis.
I think he knew that. He was going to try to hide the ball and bring it back, and as he brought it back, it was slapped out of bounds.
Hate to tell Blackner this, but Guyman was waiting for him to shoot,
yeah.
Anyway. Three by Miller. Other direction. No good. And a pushing foul on the rebound by Flinders. As
yeah.
Penetrating in there was Detling, and Flinders just said, well, I'm not going to let him get the rebound. I got to push him.
I think they
call it on bottom. Huh? I thought
yeah.
It was Flinders that pushed him.
I did too, but that's the way they went.
23-25, whatever. Neither in foul trouble. Now out to Blackner. It's cuff guarding Blackner now. See what the superstar can do. Now they switch and Flinders goes out on him, making him go left.
Yep.
And they give the ball off to Lambeth. And baseline, it goes to Detling, and he had traveled, Mike. He just
got
happy feet.
Yeah, took a little extra hop there.
You know why?
I do.
Who was hanging behind him right there?
6'7" of him was hanging there right behind him. Absolutely. Richard Guyman.
Still 33-29. Dixie by four. 2.5 to go. Well, 2:10 to go in the third quarter. Dixie has not solved this matchup zone of Canview, and Canview does a good job disguising it. They go inside to Guyman. Guyman up off the glass and good and a foul. Chance for a 3-point play.
They do count the bucket. They do call the fouls. Watching the official, as we watch it on the replay there, perfectly placed high up in the air. The only guy who can get that high is Richard Guyman, and he laid it in.
I believe they got Detling on the foul. His second. Big body in there trying to work Guyman over, but Guyman.
Just
too good that time, huh?
Yep, overpowered him.
Chance for the 3-point play. Free throw, got the roll.
One of those ain't pretty, but it counts the same as a pretty one, so.
Back to a 7-point lead. In fact, this might be the biggest lead of Matt's the biggest lead of the game for Dixie. As Lambeth goes top of the key to Huxford. Now baseline, it goes to Blackner. Blackner has it blocked away. Goes back to Canyonview. Three out of the corner, is up and good. And that was Detling with the three.
Apparently a quick timeout was called for and taken by Canyon View.
30 or a full? We'll wait for the official to signal it. It is a 30-second timeout. We'll take a 30-second break. Be right back.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
Look up at the Air Care Professionals Air Conditioning and Heating Clock, 1:39 to go in the third quarter. It is 36-32. Dixie has led by as many as 7, a 3 just now by Detling, has made it a 4-point game. Flyers with the basketball.
It kind of reminds me, actually, of the Desert Hills game earlier, is They're always leading, but they can never quite pull away. And right now, Canyonview says, we're not letting you get away from us.
Flinders drives all the way in and scores, but on the floor before the shot, a reaching foul called. That'll be on Branson Blackner. I believe that's his second foul of the game. And coaches to our right, the Canyonview coaches say, what about the hook on the offensive player?
That's what you always say when your guy gets fouled or causes a foul. I don't blame him.
1:20 to go. Quarter number three. Getting away maybe with a little travel there was Bottoman. He gives it to Flinders. Dixie kind of pulling it out a little bit. And shot from the corner. Nope. They decide not to shoot it. Over to Cuff. Cuff with a minute to go in the quarter. Gives to Caden Elzey. Back to Cuff. Three out of the corner. Tanner Cuff, no good. And a rebound. Bounce. Miller can't handle it, and it goes out of bounds off of Canyonview.
Yeah, I was watching that. The officials were right there. Actually, it looked like Canyonview's player backed off thinking it was their ball, but they're not going to get it.
Text from my friend Roger Christensen, who is the PA announcer for Dixie High, as Dixie misses the shot. He says Canadi is hurt. I did not know that.
Wow.
And Blackner goes all the way in and scores, and it's a two-point game. Branson Blackner now with 14 in the game. And right back at you says Camden Flinders as he penetrates and scores.
Oh, I like that. Just extended the two-step, got it up and in.
Dixie 38. Canyonview 34. Blackner with a nice drop off. Miller lays it up and in. Blackner starting to heat up with the pass.
And that's where Miller looks good, though. He's down low. He went strong to the hole right between two Dixie defenders.
I don't know that Guyman has been off the floor today, has he?
I don't
Richard
think so.
Guyman. I think he's played every minute of this game.
We're down
to 7 seconds to go. Dixie needs to go. Flinders gets the screen from Guyman. Tries the alley-oop, but it's tipped away and stolen by Canyonview. And the quarter will end with a 38-36 game. The Falcons hanging in there with Dixie High. We'll be back in 1 minute.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard, break time at the office, or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom Cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Welcome back to the Smith Spectrum in Logan, Utah. A couple of replays for those of you streaming with us. Nice little drive there late in the half by Camden Flinders. And here's Blackner. Beautiful dish off to Porter Miller. As we go into this final quarter with a two-point game. I can't remember, Mike. Has Canyonview even had the lead in this game? Let's see. It'll say so on our stats, but we'll have to check that in a minute. Canyonview did lead by two early in the second quarter, so they've had a very short-lived lead in this game. Right now, they're within two of Dixie. T.Y. Curtis with the ball at the top of the key. Lamb checking him. Now he'll back things out. Coach Cuff calling out what play they want to run.
Yeah, Curtis was keeping an eye close on the coach. Where are you going, coach?
Curtis to Elzey. Elzey in the lane. Little runner up, no good. Probably thought he got fouled. He got a little bumped going in the lane, but no call. And Canview now with a chance to take the lead with the three. Blackner to Miller. Miller drives all the way in. Acrobatic shot, no good. Rebound to Cuff. Cuff gives it to Curtis. Dixie wants to run. But Curtis will slow it down now.
Now they have to because defense got back pretty quick that time.
Into Guyman. Guyman spin move off the glass, no good. And a bumping foul call. That's a tough call for the defender, Miller, on that one because Guyman was throwing all kinds of little elbows and stuff. But, you know, in basketball, they tend to give the as I look at it again on replay, that's a defensive foul. Good call. Offense usually gets the benefit of the doubt. Ball comes into Elzey, a three off the inbound, no good. Rebound taken down by Dixie, kick it back out to Elzey. Curtis was a guy on the offensive glass. Curtis looks inside to Guyman. Guyman, clearance in space, goes in the lane, nearly has it stolen away. Ball hits the floor, saved by Dixie, back outside to Cuff. And Dixie can reset. They wanted to travel, but Guyman didn't have the ball. Yeah. They had it stripped away. There was
no
travel.
He was traveling, but he didn't have the ball. Good point.
And back out to Elzy. Elzy, finger roll in the lane, up and good. Nice drive off the kick.
Boy, he just went strong to the hole. It's like the waters parted. He said thank you and laid it in.
Elzy, who averages about 12 a game, he's got 8 in this one. Miller in the corner, 3 out of the corner, up too hard, no good. Rebound to Guyman. That was Huxford who tried to hit the 3. He can hit it, but it wouldn't go for him. 6:14 left in the game. Dixie 40, Canyonview 36. Cuff on the angle right, looks to Stewart. Stewart in the high post. Takes a dribble, has the ball tipped away. Saved it, and timeout called by Dixie as Stewart dived on the ball, and a little applause by the Canyonview coaches for the pressure there. 30-second timeout, we'll take it. Back in 30.
Want to make your HDTV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. And we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
We're back here at the Smith Spectrum in Logan, Utah. Actually, Mike, graduated from Utah State University with a journalism degree, covered the Aggies in this building for 3 years, but that was so long ago. I'll be quite honest, I hardly remember the place. Isn't that terrible? I'm old, I guess.
Yeah.
It was 91 is when we left, so 26 years ago. Not as old as you, though.
No, that's true.
Dixie with the basketball and a 4-point lead with under 6 minutes to go in the game. Flyers are going to pull it out. And, you know, there's been a lot of discussion lately about shot clock in high school basketball. And this is one of the reasons why. Cuff drives all the way in, shot up, no good, blocking foul called. I thought Cuff did a good job that time of jumping sideways as he went to the hole, thus making the official, making a much more difficult decision. Fans, of course, here on to our right wanted a charge, and to the left, they wanted the block, and block is the call. Cuff to the line.
Cuff steps up and, boy, yeah, bounces that one in. You know, notice free throw shooting has not been a pretty thing so far here in this tournament.
Yeah, I hate that. I'm a big proponent of it. You can be as good a free throw shooter as you want to be if you put the time in. Cuff only gets 1 out of 2. Good rebound by Miller. Dixie leads by 5. Here come the Falcons. Good three-point shooting team, so always something to be aware of when you've got a little lead on a team like Canyonview. Detling, a couple of dribbles to his right. Fakes the handoff to Blackner, now gives it to him. Cuff guarding Blackner, number 30 guarding number 30. On the angle left, gets a screen from Porter Miller. Now to Detling. Detling drives in, shot blocked out of there easily by Cuff. Fight for the basketball, I believe that is off of Caden Elzy.
Or Elzy, excuse me, absolutely.
And it will be Canyonview ball.
He was right there. The ball was blocked down and it hit his leg and rolled out of bounds.
Cuff has got at least 4 blocks in this game, maybe more. 4 that I can recall with my memory right now, but like I said, I'm old. Not as old as Mike, but old.
You don't really have to bring it up again just in case you don't want to.
Hard drive and Blackner goes in, lowers the shoulder, offensive foul called. I think a really good call, and I don't want to sound like a Dixie homer, but he lowered that shoulder, and I think that gave the ref the impetus to say, when you lower the shoulder like that, I got to call it on offense. Third foul on Blackner. Dixie by 5, 5 minutes to go. Mike, you like them pulling the ball out at this point,
I think. But you got to be, you can't pull it out and run off time and then do nothing with it. You've got to score eventually. You're not up that much. 6 points, it's anybody's game, especially with the three-point shooting of the Falcons.
T.Y. Curtis out near midcourt, keeping the dribble. I'm not close enough to get the close to guarded rule. Here comes the trap, and it's too late. Now to Cuff. Cuff, little runner up off the glass. That's no good. Rebound to Blackner. Blackner wants to run. Throws it ahead, but the ball's tipped and stolen away. No foul either way called. His body's hit the deck. Goes ahead to Cuff. Cuff thought about the 3. Coach's son decided, no, I'm not going to do that. Now he's handling the ball well. A lot more playing time today for Tanner Cuff absolutely. Than I've ever seen. But with Cannon Dye being injured, that's part of it. Now Curtis, 4:04 left. Curtis drives in the lane. Gives it off to Guymon. Guymon almost dunked it, but he did lay it in, and the lead is 7.
I think we're all expecting that to be hammered, but he says, yeah, I'll just settle that one home.
9 points in the game for Guymon. 7 points the lead for Dixie with 3:45 to go. And a little reaching foul, bumping foul called on Curtis out high. No free throws yet. That's a team foul number 7. I spoke too soon. That is a free throw situation for Joey Lambeth.
7-point lead. That's still a dangerous lead right now, but beats the heck out of anything under 7.
Lambeth has 5 points in the game, but none in the second half. He'll have a chance to rectify that situation right now. 1-1 free throw is good. Big front end of 1-1 for Joey.
I agree. This is where you really have to hit your free throw. You got to hit everything you can. Keep yourself in position.
Second one, too hard, no good, and a rebound to Stewart. Stewart is a surprisingly good rebounder, by the way, even though he's not a real big guy.
He's just aggressive. I like his ability to just go hard every time.
43-37, Dixie up by 6, 3:30 left in the basketball game. Curtis backs things out. Nearly has it stolen away. Good save by Tanner Cuff. Now to Elzie. Elzie thought about driving. He backed things out. Now he does go, but he should have maybe held on to that one because he missed the shot.
He had Guymon open in the corner, but elected not to go with him.
Into Miller. Miller hard drive. Kick around the horn to Blackner. Blackner fakes a 3. Drives in the lane. Reverse layup. Wow, what a shot by Branson Blackner.
Wow, how'd he get that? Reverse English. Falling forward, flips it back up and in.
He's got 16 points, 3 minutes left. Dixie now leads by 4. Maybe the pulling the ball hasn't worked for Dixie this time.
Yeah, it might not.
The lead was 7, now it's 4. Caden Elzie with the basketball, Blackner guarding him. Back to Curtis, 2:40 left in the game. Curtis drives, now backs out of there. Drives, now backs out again. Still out in 3-point land, gives it up to Cuff. Cuff drives, was all the way in and backs it back out. Little runner, one-hander, no good. Rebound to Canyon View. The Falcons with a chance now, but it's stolen away. Taken by Cuff. Cuff had an open 3, didn't take it. Canyon View screaming for a foul on that one. They're not going to get it.
Nope.
Cuff to Curtis. 2:12 left. Still a 4-point lead for Dixie. Skip it across to Elzie. Elzie will drive hard in the lane. Finger roll up. That won't go. Tip out. Saved by Curtis. Who had the tip out? That was Elzie, I think, right?
I think so. Wow, what a tip.
Offensive rebounds just killing Canyon View. Elzie drives in again. Goes to Stewart. Stewart, finger roll. That's no good. Blackner on the rebound. Dixie somehow keeping Canyon View alive by missing layups.
Let's double check. Is there a lid on that basket?
Blackner all the way in, and he is fouled. Thought he was going to go to the left hand. Probably Guymon would have blocked the lefty, so he went right to create the foul. There's that reverse layup we watch on the internet.
Here's the last shot again.
Here's the foul. See, he looked like he was going left, and then he went right because he knew he could get body contact.
It was blocked by the big guy. So 1:38. Wow. 4-point ball game. Could be 2 after a couple of free throws.
Blackner, good free throw shooter, hits the first one. Branson Blackner now with 17 in the game. And if he gets his 18th points, which is his average, Mike, 18.2, yeah, they will be within 2 with 1:38 left. What a game. We're going to go right down to the wire here. That one, though, will not go, so the lead remains 3. First miss at the line for Blackner. And here comes Curtis trapped in the backcourt, gives it to Cuff. And Dixie's going to...
Yeah,
probably
Coach
a good
got
move.
A little nervous, didn't he, down there?
Coach Cuff calls a timeout. We'll see if it's a full or a 30. Full. It is a full timeout. We'll take a 1-minute break with 89 seconds left in the game and Dixie up by 3.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
Dixie is 6 out of 9 from the free throw line in this game. Now, they've only shot once, three since halftime. 2 out of 3 in the second half. Canyon didn't shoot a free throw in the first half, but since then, the Blackner 5 out of 6, Lambeth 1 out of 2, and Miller 0 for 2. So that's 6 out of 10 from the line for the Falcons in the second half. Dixie looking to get it in. Fake the deep pass and instead go in the backcourt to Curtis. Curtis to Cuff. 1:25 to go, clock ticking. Cuff crosses over, gets it across the timeline. Gives it up to Ty Curtis. Curtis not closely guarded yet, now he is. And he gives it up to Elzy. Elzy goes around to Reitz, goes all the way in, now back outside to Stewart. They actually take Guyman out of the game here. Not a great free throw shooter. Into Curtis, back out to Flinders, and Flinders is grabbed and held. And with 1:01 left, Dixie's gonna go to the line with a 3-point lead, and I spoke too soon. That's only 16 fouls, or is that the seventh, Mike?
That is the seventh. Okay. Yeah.
So big 1-1 free throw coming now for Camden Flinders.
Now they bring Guyman, back in.
Yeah, defensive purposes. Flinders didn't play early in the year, had an injury. I believe it was a hand injury. But he made a splash on the scene. I think his first game back, he had 4 3-pointers. And he misses the 1-1.
Wow.
And so can you with hope down by just 3.
Yeah.
And here come the Falcons. Huxford throws it away. And they wanted a timeout. Blackner was screaming for a timeout, but the ball was thrown away before they could get it called. So it'll be Dixie basketball. Well, what happened on that one? Looked like Lambeth maybe started to cut in and was going to come back out, but before he could, the ball had been thrown. Dixie gets it in. Elzy in the backcourt, 50 seconds to go. Gets it across the timeline. Here comes a double team. Little jump pass to Curtis. Back to Elzy. No, stolen away. Layup on the run. Lambeth up, and he misses the layup. Wide open layup, and it won't go. Dixie now with numbers the other way, and Elzy's going to slow it down. Caden Elzy on the sideline, and timeout Flyers. Oh, my goodness, Mike McGarry. Joey Lambeth missed a shot. That would have made it a 1-point game.
Yeah, we'll just say it. It could be a game breaker right there. I mean, he did a great job. He anticipated.
Beautiful steal. Yeah.
Poked it out. He was the only one there, went down and kind of relaxed. Just left it short at the rim. Wow.
That hurts. So
they're not done.
We'll reset. We'll do the game reset for you. 32.2 on the clock. Dixie with the basketball. Both teams in the single bonus, not the double bonus. So it'll be 1-1 free throws either direction. The possession arrow points toward Canyonview. So if they can get a tie up, they get the basketball back.
But that is not a lot of time, Dixie, though. I tell you what, the pressure of Canyonview has been fairly effective against the Flyers.
I think they're going to foul instantaneously. I can't imagine them letting any more time go off the clock. If Dixie makes a clean catch, I think that Canyonview will foul. Who do you want going to the line, Mike? Flinders just missed.
Boy, I don't know.
Elzy, maybe?
Maybe Elzy.
Ball comes into Curtis. Curtis faked the drive, then went back outside to Flinders. Flinders to Curtis, now to Elzy. Elzy holds on, and he is slapped. Kind of slapped back after he got fouled.
Yeah, he did. I think
got to be careful there. But they do call the personal foul on Abe Huxford, and going to the line will be Caden Elzy.
Back in comes the big guy once again, play a little defense. And also,
pretty good coaching, I think, eight offense for defense. How about this? See who's coming into the game, Mike?
Wow.
The injured, we think, Cannon Dye, just entered the game. With 24 seconds left, he hasn't played 1 second in this game.
This is called rolling the dice a little bit by Coach Cuff, maybe.
So Caden Elzy, true 1-1, 24 seconds to go. Free throw. Good.
Got it.
It's a 4-point game.
George Gervin.
The Iceman, huh?
I just hadn't heard that name for a long time.
Appropriate for up here in the ice.
Yeah, the land of the ice and snow.
One more coming for Caden Elzey to try to make it a five-point game. Free throw. Got the roll. Wow. It's a five-point lead for the Flyers. Clock rolling, under 20 now. Skip pass across to Huxford. Huxford throws it away, stolen by Dixie. Cannon die, the guy with the steal. How about the roll of the dice that time, Mike? And now a foul in the backcourt on Curtis. But Cannon die, I don't know what the injury is, but he just made a huge play late in this game.
Wow. Yeah, I was looking at the coach. You can see the big grin and the pump of the fist, and I thought, yeah, a pat on the back would go there to the coach too. Nice time to insert your guy. He goes in. That's the perfect thing.
They play 31 minutes and 36 seconds without him. And he comes in the last 24 seconds, makes a nice defensive steal. Now Dixie with 11.7 on the clock, and Curtis hits the free throw.
And just about puts this one away.
Curtis with 7 points, 10 for LZ. It's the same old Dixie, not one real star, just a bunch of guys doing good things. That's a 6-point. This would make it a 3-possession game. Can't get it to go. Canyonview will hurry it up the floor. Well, they need to hurry it up the floor. Blackner comes up, kicks it in the corner. Three out of the corner by Lambeth is up and good with 2 seconds to go. Timeout. They probably ought to put a second or two back on the clock because after the whistle, it ran for a full second, Mike.
I'm watching the very exuberant bench of Canyonview. They were discussing things, should we say, with the official.
We're going to keep it right here. They have, at this point, not put any time, and it doesn't look like they're going to, Mike.
Well, the one official came over, and they may be conferencing right now to see if there is any time that should be added on, but you're right.
Well, it's not when they call the timeout. It's when the official acknowledges it and blows his whistle, and I think they're talking about that right now because as soon as he blew the whistle, I looked up at the clock, and it ran for a full second. It was 2.5. Now it's 1.4. 2.5 is about what it should be.
3.1.
3.1? Well, the whistle didn't blow till 2.5, so.
We'll see if the officials put a little bit of time back.
Either way, they should put some, I think. But it is a 3-point game now after that three by Lambeth. A little bit of redemption for Joey after he missed that layup a moment ago.
Yep.
That would have cut it to one. His three cuts it to a 3-point game. Nice hit out of the corner after the pass by Blackner.
Watching the replay right now.
I think everybody expected Blackner to shoot. And
well, he drew the attention to him and got it up and in. Still nothing up on the clock, although they're talking about it. I have a feeling we're going to get something.
Well, they put 1.0. That's actually less. I think they're trying to make it 2.0 maybe.
Yeah, hold up, said the official. They got to get the clock right.
We've had some clock issues. We've had some phone line issues.
We've had a game.
We haven't had any internet issues though.
There we go. 1.9, Andy.
They put a half a second up. So basically, Canyonview needs a steal and a three, and Dixie's going to take another timeout with 1.9 on the clock.
Actually, I think Canyonview called the timeout.
Oh, did they?
What they did is they got out, saw what Dixie had set up, called timeout. Now they will set for hopefully playing some defense here.
We're not going to go anywhere. We don't want to miss anything. Recap the scorers for you. Looks like 17-19 in the game for Blackner. No, 17. He missed that free throw for Blackner. 9 points for Joey Lambeth after that three that he just made. Nobody else with more than six, although Porter Miller is the guy with six for Canyonview. For Dixie, Elzey with 10. He is the only Dixie player in double figures. Ty Curtis has 7. 9 points for Richard Guyman and 6 for Tanner Cuff. Cannon Dye, his game time will be 24 seconds and one steal.
Yeah. Well, it turns out to be a pretty good steal.
If you can average one steal every 24 seconds, you'd be a superstar, right?
Yeah, you would. All right, so we do it again. 1.9 seconds on the clock here.
Again, possession arrow to Canyonview. So if there is a quick tie-up, I think the tie-up's going to take 2 seconds by itself, so may not be a factor. Fouls, there are 9 now on Canyonview, so any foul would be a two-shotter.
Remember,
and, of course, one free throw would end it.
Remember back in the day, they used to say you had to have at least point something second in order to even have a chance?
Yeah.
Now they just say, ah, go ahead.
Dixie's got to get it in. Cuff gets it to Curtis. Curtis fouled immediately. 9/10 of a second go off the clock. So T.Y. Curtis with one free throw will clinch this basketball game. Dixie by three with 1 second to go.
Yep. Wow, we've been treated to a couple of good ball games here. A lot of good. Well, I'd say one was a little bit lopsided.
Yeah, by the way, Ridgeline advanced. They had a big win with a big crowd here. Curtis there makes the free throw, and that's going to send Dixie to the semifinals. And timeout taken, I think, by Dixie.
This was a Dixie timeout. Now, this one I'm not sure.
The only thing I can think of is don't foul, let them have anything they want.
Well, you want to make sure that everybody, yeah, is on the same page.
Because the only thing that would save them at this point would be a 4-point play.
Yeah. So they say, Dixie, stand next to your coach.
Yeah, I wouldn't even, yeah.
Or go stand on
let
the court.
Let them have whatever they want, yeah.
Wow, well, if this holds up, and we assume it's going to here, that will send the two Region 9 boys teams into the championship bracket tomorrow night.
Yeah, 7:30 semifinal for Desert Hills and Ridgeline, 9:10 p.m. for Dixie, and we don't know who.
That's right.
Juan Diego taking on Richfield.
Richfield, kind of a...
They're the uninvited guests,
they're
right?
The uninvited, yeah, they did
well. They
went
to Grantsville and beat a Grantsville team that had like 18 wins this year.
Juan Diego knocked Pineview out of the playoffs here with a big win at their home the other night.
Yep, 5-point win last Friday. Branson Blackner's bummed out. You can see the look on his face. He's disappointed.
Yeah, yeah.
Be his final high school. No, he's a junior, right?
I don't have the stats in front of me here.
I have to look that one up. I think Branson is a junior. Free throw good, so that's it. 5-point lead. Canyon View will fling it at half court at the buzzer. It's no good. And Dixie will hold on to a 48-43 victory over Canyon View. The Flyers advance to the state semifinals. Canyon View season comes to an end with a 14-11 record, and the Region 12 champs just couldn't quite get there.
Couldn't quite do it. A big rematch of these former and soon to be again region teams.
Great ball game. Canview was game. They took the lead once or twice in the second quarter. Never quite got over the hump. They did tie it in the third quarter, but never got over the hump. And then Dixie's able to ice it with free throws at the end. Again, the Flyers win at 48-43. Let's take